Hello, just catching up on my news. This is Following Fay Street. I'm Conor Behan and we're finally here at the halfway point on our little adventure. Now, this is our last episode before a bit of a Christmas break, so let's get straight into it. Well, Louise has certainly changed her tune. She's gone from being Little Miss Career into Little Miss Serial Dater in just two episodes. This week she heads on a date with college flame Harrison, who she actually fancies. Now, he seems like a bit of a wild man.
We blagged our way around every nightclub and VIP section and all that, pretending that we were the Blizzards.
Crazy. Still, at least Louise gets a happy ending. Nice one, Louise. We do think he missed out on a couple of seduction techniques, though. I mean, you could have told him to
take your top off.
And after you kissed him, you could have said,
congratulations.
Take care.
Still, well done, Louise. Well done. Danny bounces back big time this week. There she is, polishing glasses at Four Dame Lane and getting Cici to make cocktails when some guys from a tattoo parlour approach her with a job offer. And there she is, looking all glam at her 21st when they offer her the job. Amazing. Too bad she's a
agent.
Hang on, could it be?
Off.
We're so glad Paul is back to win Danny's heart, and it turns out he's as charming as ever.
You're a f***ing agent.
Apparently all of Danny's friends are
f***ing agents.
Although
them f***ing agents are my friends, Paul.
So hang on, does that make
you think I'm a f***ing agent then?
Or Paul?
You're a f***ing agent.
This is a lot to take, isn't it?
You're being stupid.
Alright Paul, calm down. No need to be a
f***ing agent, Paul.
You're f***ing agents, like.
You're f***ing agents.
Maybe I think they are.
With Paul back in the picture and Stephen still on the scene, it's hard for Danny to decide which slice of man to take as her own. So to help her out, we've assembled a list of their good and bad points. You're welcome, Danny. I can't lie, I briefly saw a side of Vogue this week that I didn't really like. I mean, she was lying to her bosses and getting Louise into trouble. This isn't the deadly sound ride bag I've come to love. What gives? Still, it's not long before Vogue's true colours as the coolest girl in the world return. She fesses up to her mistakes and lets Louise have the stellar job. Vogue, she's just like us. She makes mistakes. She's human like you and me. Except hotter. Way, way, way hotter. With all the excitement of the last 6 weeks, there's still only one girl we want to talk to. This is our exclusive interview with Cici.
Hi, how's it going? I'm Cici Kavanagh from Fay Street. I'm gonna go through the highs and lows and pressures of being on such a successful series. Enjoy. But I mean, I can tell you about Louise. But I'm really stressed, we make this quick, okay? Louise is really into fashion. When it comes to clothes, money is no object.
How nice is that?
1,000 euro.
Such a waste of money.
Louise is like really supportive of her friends. Like she's so supportive to Danny.
You're all mine. I'm gonna keep you locked up in the apartment now.
I'm dying for one of these. I've none left, so stressed. Danny works really hard. She works really well under pressure. I'm really stressed, I don't wanna talk about Paul. I have 7 essays to do, and you want to talk about Paul? He really likes Danny, and I know the reason he got so aggressive with Stephen is that he's jealous that he fits into those skinny jeans, and Paul doesn't.
And you f*** off.
I reckon Paul has some issues with his weight. Who doesn't these days? I'm really stressed. He got a lighter. Seriously, got a lighter. Everyone thinks Vogue is named after a magazine. She's actually named after my favourite brand of cigarettes, also called Vogue. To be honest though, I'd smoke anything as long as it lit. Vogue is like the best DJ in the country. She's like Paula Cabell with a bigger set of tits. I think Veg is really cool because, like, she's just tall, blonde and gorgeous and she doesn't give a shit. Much like the way I'm short, brown haired and gorgeous but don't give a shit. Steven and Kevin are really nice guys. They're in a really great band called the Karate Kids. So yeah, I mean, being on Patreon really changed my life. As opposed to just being a girl about town, I'm a girl about town on television. Does anyone have a lighter? I really need to smoke. Look, I don't have time to talk about myself. I'm really busy. I'm promoting a new club night called Faux Leather Pants. That's gonna be huge. And I had to leave because I have a lot of work to do. Yeah, no, look, this interview's over. Really stressed. Catch us later, okay? Thanks a million for watching me on Face Street. Bye!
There you have it. 6 episodes of life, love, and amazing moments. Faith Street is back in the new year and I for one cannot wait. Will Louise and Danny still be friends? Will Vogue ever stop being deadly? Or will Paul tell anyone to Who knows? Overall, we have to say
congratulations.
Take care.
To everyone involved for making some fantastic TV. It truly was.
Awesome.
With Christmas on the way, I know what I'm doing.
I'm going to Marbella.
But I'll see you here when I get back. Talk to you soon.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. Shut up, that's awesome.